Hi. So behind me is the, yes, I know it's not, I'm not going to be able to give its full beauty, but it's the Niagara Falls. It is actually phenomenal. And I came for a walk and with a book, a friend of mine, her book, Yoke. Her name's Bernadette Summers. I highly recommend this book. I started reading it on the plane. Oh, Margaret, hello. Hi, and hi, Lee. I felt called to, oh, Indy, hello. I'm at, literally, I've just arrived yesterday at Niagara Falls, and tomorrow start a Dr. Joe Dispenza week-long advanced retreat, which will be my third in just under 12 months. And I felt it was really fitting to come on, and I'm probably going to get emotional because it's a really big, big time for me. So I'm marking this time as it's really stepping into my future. Hello, Christina. So 12 months ago, I took myself off to my first Joe Dispenza retreat on the Sunshine Coast last September. And that retreat, during that time, in a very short space of time, something cracked open and I had an awareness that I hadn't, a new awareness. And that new awareness led me down the path, or led my ex-husband now and I down a path to separate. So that was just under 12 months ago. Then I went back and did another retreat, another one on the Sunshine Coast in April, because I thought, shit, if I've started it now, I've got to continue with this work. And during that time, another milestone occurred. We signed the paperwork to sell the house to one buyer. It was a very easy process, and it was one that I truly did believe that I created. That's the point of all this work, is that we do create our reality. And then this time, the day before I flew out to Niagara Falls, I signed the financial agreement for our separation. Whew. So all within 12 months, and when I went away last September, I had no idea what was in store for me. I went there with an open mind, which I always do, and I went there with a willingness to get beyond my current self, because that's the purpose of, well, my purpose in life, is to keep unravelling and unfolding and undoing the conditioning that I've been conditioned by, so that I can come back to wholeness and oneness and unconditional love, where I know that I don't need anything outside of me for me to feel happy or enough. Or so it's the point of this post, I suppose, is one for me to mark it as a moment in time, having really stepped into the unknown and feel like I've literally thrown everything up in the air and I don't know what's ahead of me. I know I'm alive, I know I have three healthy boys, I know I have a relationship intact with my ex-husband, which is great. I have a house, a beautiful home that I've created. I don't really know what else is in front of me. And so I think this is the point of life, isn't it? That we can be so afraid that we just are paralyzed by fears, or we step into them and we step and we move through them and we keep moving one foot at a time in front of each other, of one another, of, what am I trying to say? You know what I mean. And I think when we keep coming back, what I'm finding is, because I don't know, and there is so much unknown, and we're all so friggin' afraid of the unknown. But what I'm recognizing more and more is, as I step into the unknown and then something occurs and synchronicities arise and people arrive in my, you know, in my space, or we sell the house to one buyer and it's an easy process, or I find the house of my dreams and rent it really easily, even though there's 19 applicants. It's just face, just constantly coming back to face that, we're always supported, that there is a greater force that has a, that is pulling us forward. And it's up to us to align with that force, and up to us not to resist it, not to resist the flow, but to allow it and to listen to it and to be guided by it, which is, you know, our intuition. And So thank you for all of you that are here. Oh, hello, Kathy. Just up at Niagara Falls, not up at, I'm over in Niagara Falls doing my third retreat for 12 months, as I was just sharing. So yeah, a big 12 months. But I think this year's been really, really big for a lot of people. And when it is that way, it's coming back to things, you know, I was saying to a client the other day, we've got to learn to be softer with ourselves. Softness doesn't mean that we're in action. It just means that we're more allowing, we're more gentle with ourselves, softer, we're kinder, we're just taking pauses to acknowledge also that this is life. That, I don't know about you, but I want to live a full life. I want to live an extraordinary life from here on in. I don't feel like I have. I haven't lived the life that I've come here to live, and I certainly am now. And I'm doing it with courage, and I fall over. Now, somebody was saying the other day to me, please don't let people think that you're doing it easy. I said, my goodness, I don't think I'm letting anyone think that I'm doing this. Well, I am choosing ease, but at the same time, I have moments. I have moments where it's overwhelming. I have moments when I feel grief for all that I've not given up, but that I have said no to. And that's life, isn't it? It's just taking all of it. So I thought I was going to try and finish off with a view of the falls, and I don't know if I'm going to be able to. It's seriously stunning. Seriously stunning. I did a walking meditation this morning and ended up overlooking the falls, but I just don't think I'm going to be able to do this justice. No, I'm not, because it's like through the trees. But I will take something later on. I'm going to say goodbye. And yeah, wow. Thank you for whoever was here with me today and who's been part of the last 12 months. It's been a full-on ride, but one that I have no regrets about. None. Okay, I'll keep posting, because this space, this place is amazing. Love to all of you. See you, Kathy, whoever else is here. Bye.